I'm Kirsty Meakey. Welcome to the Nao Nails channel. Anyway, we're going to do some nails. We're going to do some gold and silver foiled nails. Before I start, can you make sure you subscribe, please? Come on now, please. I beg you. Yes, I'm begging. Okay. Please subscribe. Don't forget to press the notification bell and press all. Anyway, thanks for that. Have you done it? Okay, thanks. Right. That's real. We can crack on now. On my big fat thumb. I hate my thumbs. They're just like really weird because they're dead big here and then they go all skinny. But anyway, I think most thumbs do that. What I'm going to do is sculpt out a nail that is a stiletto to match my others because I want to have a beautiful set of nails. It's not like me to have a beautiful set of nails because I don't particularly enjoy doing my own nails. I enjoy doing everybody else's nails. Don't really.
But how long will they last?
How long will they last until I go, oh, they're too long, I need to take them off.
Until you've done all your photos and then they come off.
I'm going to take some nice photos and then I think I'll just cut them down. However, I do actually really love them and I just wish I could wear them this long. And you never know, I might get used to it and I might just be able to. So we'll see how long they last. So can you see how my skin is pushing out that foam and making it quite fat? So what I'm going to do is take a itty bitty teeny weeny pair of scissors and go down the sides. And I'm doing this on myself, so it's really quite easy. Don't be thinking I'm going to cut myself, because I can feel it is. If you're doing it on a client, you want to kind of do it before so you can line it up. I'm just going to cut here and here so I can fold this out like that. Like so. And then I can close the form a little tighter, which will give a nice C curve. Everything will fit a little nicer and it won't be so wide. So you can see now it's a lot narrower. That's what we want. So I'm just gonna dehydrate the nail with the Nail Prep Dehydrator. And then we're gonna prime with the Ultra Bond Primer. So I'm gonna pick up a sort of medium to large bead. And then we're going to make contact with the natural nail. And then with the bulk of that product, we're going to pat and press and pull that down the length of the sculpting form. So you're always behind it and you're always kind of like, it's like you're sliding it down. Next bead. Then I'm going to sort the cuticle out first of all, make sure that's nice and neat. I'm going to add a little bit of liquid to the sides there and across the actual nail. So when I pat and press and pull this down, it connects nicely. So I'm just making sure I've got enough everywhere, making sure I've not missed any spots. And I can just see a tiny bit there that needs doing. I'm just going to let that set for about a minute because what I want to do is be able to pinch this without it still being like squishable. Yeah, that is a word. In my world, it's a word.
I think everybody has something squishable in their world.
Mm-hmm. That probably only took about 30 seconds. It is quite warm in this room though. It's because we've had the lights on all day. It's gone a little bit warm. The warmer the room, the quicker the product will set. The colder the room, it will take longer to set, but it could also crystallise. So you need to have, you know, a sort of, what, 19 degrees? Is that the perfect temperature? 19 to 21 degrees. I'd say it's about 25 at the minute here. So I can pinch down the length. Wow. You don't want to over-pinch. Pinching too hard when it causes pain is not good. Just open those back tabs because I'm going to take it off in a moment. There we are. So if you listen, this is very set. It's a higher pitched sound. That's still a little bit. It's getting there. The reason this is set quite quick is because my thumb is so warm. Right, so now we're going to file these sidewalls, get them nice and straight. So I'm coming under the nail to do that. I'm going to use my electric file to come round this cuticle area. And I'm going to remove some bulk. Start to smooth. I've gone to a 180 grit file now, just a little bit softer so I can skip around the cuticle a little bit. Not going to hurt my skin. Unlike I did on this one, because I didn't use the e-file and I just went straight in with the file, down to pure laziness and cut myself. Yes, I too am human and make mistakes. Right, give it a buff. Make it nice and smooth. Give it a dust. Right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to use tarnished silver as a base to work with. Because when I put the gold and silver leaf on, I do want something in the background. Right, let's pop that in. Get it in a lamp, give it a cure. And then what we're going to do on top of that is we're going to use the foil glue. Now this is a gel based glue. You can use it with foil and you can also use it with the silver and gold leaf. I'm going to pop that in. Make sure you cover the entire nail, because if you don't, it ain't going to stick. So we're going to cure that. So it won't air dry. It needs to be cured in an LED or UV lamp. So once that's been in the lamp for 30 seconds, I'm going to take, now we've got silver leaf foil. And we've also got gold. We're going to use both. And I'm literally going to peel off that little bit. So we won't need a lot. So it's so fly away, and I've got some little pieces of gold already here. I'm going to touch that on quite random places and that will stick. So, I'm a little bit on the end here, I think. Maybe one last little bit, kind of through here. That's it. Nice. Then we're going to take the silver one. I'm going to put that all the way over the top, like that. And I'm going to get this dusting brush and keep dusting. And as we dust, it's going to start to reveal some of the gold as well. You can see how it's coming through. What you can do is you can actually scratch away a little bit, Luke. I'm going to add a little bit more gold. So you can build on your design and you can layer. And what I'm going to do now is, it looks lovely like that, but I'm going to etch into this with a sharp tool, could be a dotting tool, and create like little cracks. I want it to look as if it's like a broken mirror, I suppose. It'll just add texture. stuffed off any excess that may have lifted whilst you were doing that.
So you can just fill in little bits.
Yeah, you can just keep adding. It will stick to itself as well. But to get the best adhesion, you do need the foil glue.
Okay.
All right, so now we're going to top coat this. So this is the Urban Graffiti top coat. Make sure you catch right around the edges. I am going to top coat this twice because I've cut into it with the tool. I don't want that to affect the adhesion of the foil. And then before my next top coat, I'm going to take the file. You could do it with a buffer or a file. And I'm just going to file the edge to make sure that I have no foil underneath. Because I'm going to put top coat on this part of the nail, so my brush will sweep over and catch this part, and it's going to seal everything, kind of like shrink wrap.
Shrink wrap?
Yeah, it's like it's shrink wrapping the nail in top coat. I am going to put some stones on as well. So this is the time to put the stones on. We're going to use the brand new, where are you, my best friend, Loud and Clear Acrogel. So I'm going to take a little bit of that out, just like that. It's super clear. And I'm going to place that where I want it. So I'm going to put some there, and then I'm going to put some here. Then I'm going to use a brush that has a little bit of the gel residue wipe off solution on, not a lot, and it'll just help you move that product around. And then don't cure that. You want to go in with your top coat again. Make sure you're still capping these edges. Remember, we want it to be shrink wrapped. So you're going over the entire nail. Make sure you're sweeping up those sides. Don't cure, because we're going to add bling, 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 bling. Ching, ching, bling, bling. This will kind of sink into the gel, and it's that sinking into gel that actually holds everything in place. Going to add a few micro beads. And pop that in the lamp. And then we're going to finish with some cuticle oil. This is the vanilla. I think it's quite a cool effect.
It certainly is. I didn't realise that it would show up underneath the other one.
Yeah, you just have to be a bit aggressive with the brush. But no, it's quite cool, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at that first set of nails.
Wow. That's the blingiest nails you've had in a long time.
In a long time. These are like proper night out nails, these are.
And what's one of them anymore?
I know.
A night out.
A night out. Night out nail. I've got night out nails on and nowhere to go. All blinged up and nowhere
You're
to go.
You're too old to go out now anyway.
Oh, I am not. I am not too old to go out. No, not having it. I love them.
They're very nice.
I can't wait to take pictures. So there we are. I'm feeling bougie. Proper emoji with these. There you are, guys. Hope you've enjoyed this video. Have a go. Tag us in your little nails and everything that you do. If you recreate a design, please tag us. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
the camera facing like that and I'll just keep looking at myself because I'm so beautiful. He just ignores me all the time. He just lets me rabbit on about. Yeah.